So we are in Chaitanya Charitamrita Adi Lila, chapter 37. Shukla Rakta Pita Varna Eti Na Dyuti. Satya Treta Kali Kale Dharena Pipyati. Very good. White, red, and yellow. These are the three bodily lusters that the Lord, husband of the goddess of fortune, assumes in the name of Satya, Treta, and Kali, respectively. Idanim dvapare tino haila krishna varnam. Now in Dwapara Yuga, the Lord has descended in a blackish hue. This is the essence of the statements in the Puranas and other Vedic literatures with reference to the context. So in Dwapara Yuga, he comes with a blackish color. That's what it says. Dwapare Bhagavan Shyama Pita Vasa Nija Yudha. Shri Vatsadi Birankesha Lakshana Rupa Lakshita. In the Dwapara Yuga, the personality of Godhead appears in a black hue. He is dressed in yellow. He holds his own weapons and is decorated with the Kaustubha jewel and marks of Sri Vatsa. This is how his symptoms are described. This is the verse from Srimad Bhagavatam spoken by Saint Karabhajana, one of the nine royal mystics who explained to King Nimi the different features of the Lord in different ages. So there is Karabhajana. There is a section, Karabhajana section in Srimad Bhagavatam, who is describing the Lord's qualities. So that is being repeated here in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Kali Yuga Yuga Dharma Namera Pracharam.
Kali Yuga Namera Pracharam.
Dhati Lagi Pita Varna Chaitanya Avataram. The religious practice for age of Kali is to broadcast the glories of the holy name. So broadcasting the glories of the holy name is the Kaliyuga Lakshana. Only for this purpose has the Lord in yellow color designated as Lord Chaitanya. Okay. So are you able to read, Mataji, while Prabhu is driving, or should I just read?
Yes. No, Prabhu, I can read. Okay. Purport. In this age of Kali, the practical system of religion for everyone is the chanting of the name of Godhead. This was introduced in this age by Lord Chaitanya. Bhakti Yoga actually begins with the chanting of the holy name, as confirmed by Madhavacharya in his commentary on the Mundaka Upanishad. He quotes this verse from the Narayana Samhita. Dvaparye janer Vishnu pancha ratristu kevale कलौ तु नाम मात्रेना पूज्यते भगवान हरिः. प्लीज स्क्रॉल डाउन प्रभुजी. In the Dwapar Yuga, people should worship Lord Vishnu only by the regulative principles of the Narada Pancharatra and other such authorized books. In the age of Kali, however, people should simply chant the holy names of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The Hare Krishna mantra is specifically mentioned in many Upanishads, such as the Kali Santarana Upanishad, where it is said, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Iti Soda Shakam Nam Nam Kali Kalmasha Nashanam Nataha Para Taro Payaha Sarva Vedesu Drishyate. After searching through all the Vedic literature, one cannot find a method of religion more sublime for this age than the chanting of Hare Krishna.
Very good. So I think it is self evident, clear, that in Kali Santarana Upanishad, Iti Shodak Namnam. Shodakam Namnam means 16 lettered names. Kali Kalmasha Nashanam. It destroys the effects of Kali Yuga. That's right. And then Madhvacharya is saying, Dvaparyar Janer Vishnuhu Pancharatrastu Kevalaihi Kalau Tu Nama Matrena Pujyate Bhagavan Harihi. In the Dvapar Yuga, you follow Narada Pancharatra and other literature to worship the Lord. In Kali Yuga, simply chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra. Today we went for Nagar Sankirtan and we chanted on the streets and a lot of people were waving their hands. They were dancing to the beat. Ultimately, they don't know that this is a very, very powerful thing that they are hearing. So hopefully that thing will stay with them and react within them at some point to make them devotees. Right? So Madhvacharya gave commentary on the Mundaka Upanishad. This is so interesting. And in Kali Santarana Upanishad, there is a more detail here. Okay, 341. Taptahe masama kanti prakanda shariram.
Taptahe masama kanti prakanda shariram.
Navami gajini kanta dhvani gambiram.
Navami gajini kanta dhvani gambiram.
The luster of his expansive body, this is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's body, resembles molten gold. The deep sound of his voice conquers the thundering of newly assembled clouds. Okay, 342. Dharya vistare ye apanarahatam.
Dharya vistare ye apanarahatam.
Chari hastahaya mahapurush vikyatam.
Chari hastahaya mahapurush vikyatam.
One who measures 4 cubits in height and in breadth by his own hand is celebrated as a great personality. So, this is just a mathematical calculation. Cubit used to be the olden way of measuring things. If somebody is 4 cubits high, they are considered to be an important personality. So no more detail is given by Prabhupada, so we don't know why it is so.
Prabhuji, for cubits is like how many inches or centimeter?
It is more than a feet, that much I know, but I don't know exactly how much it is.
Oh, 1 cubit is more than 1 feet?
Yeah, more than 1 feet. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very tall. He was more than 6 feet tall. So you can imagine that if you'd be saying he's 4 cubits high. So which means roughly each one of them should be what? 1.5 feet cubit. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was more than 6 feet. So maybe it is close to 2 feet each cubit. That's what I'm thinking, but we don't know. We have to confirm by scholars. By scholars, we don't.
Okay, thank you.
Such a person is called Nyagrodha Parimandala, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who personifies all good qualities as the body of Nyagrodha Parimandala. No one other than Supreme Lord himself, who has engaged the conditioned souls by his own illusory energy, can possess these bodily features. These features indicate an incarnation of Vishnu and no one else. So Prabhupada is saying if somebody is so tall, so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very tall, more like he was close to 8 feet tall. So maybe each cubit is 2 feet. Again, I don't know. We have to research further. Nyagrodha Parimandala, very interesting word. Ajanu lambita bhuja kamala lochanam.
Ajanu lambita bhuja kamala lochana.
Tila fula jini nasha sudam shuvadanam.
Tila fula jini sudanam.
His arms are long enough to reach his knees. Eyes are like lotus flowers. Nose is like sesame flower. Face is as beautiful as moon. That's why Gaura Chandra, they say. He looks like the moon. Round face. Arms are long enough to reach his knees. Even Lord Ram's arms were until his knees. So that's why we call him Ajanubahudu. Ajanubahudu means his bahu. Hands are long. Ajanu. Ajanu means till the knees. And then you also say Aravinda Netra or Kamala Lochana. Means eyes are like lotus flowers. When the eyelids move back and forth, it's like lotus petals are moving up and down like that. But this is the first time I'm hearing about this Tilafula, sesame plant. Normally, Lord is always compared to lotus feet, lotus-eyed one, Aravindaksha. Aravindaksha means he has the eyes of a lotus. Like Lord Ram's description is Ajanubahudu, Aravinda Netrudu. Means he has hands coming to his knees and his eyes are like lotuses. That is the typical description of Lord Ram. So here, the same description is being given to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Santa Danta Krishna Bhakti Nishta Parayanam.
Santa Danta Krishna Bhakti Nishta Parayanam.
Bhakta Vasala Shushila Sarva Bhute Samam. Yeah, Shila means like characteristics. Sushila means good characteristics. Right? Sometimes in India, there's people are given a name Sushil, Sushil Kumar. So it means he has good characteristics, or at least that is the hope. But who knows? Once the fellow grows up, he will have Durshil, means bad qualities. You cannot stop it, right? Some people take up to different types of association and different types of behavior. Translation, he is peaceful, self-controlled, and fully devoted to transcendental service of Lord Sri Krishna. He is affectionate towards his devotees, gentle, he is equally disposed towards all living beings. So this is the Gunanu Varnana for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That he is gentle and equally disposed towards all living beings. In Bhagavad Gita, we hear the term Samah Sarveshu Bhuteshu Mad Bhakti Labhate Param. So you have to be Samah, means equal to all living beings. And then here it is said Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was actually Samah Sarveshu Bhuteshu. Chandanera Angada Bhava Chandana Bhushanam.
Chandana Angada Bala Chandana Bhushana.
Nitya Kale Pari Karena Krishna Sankirtanam.
Nitya Kale Pari Karena Krishna Sankirtanam.
So, more description. He is decorated with sandalwood bangles. So, normally, you see, people wear gold, silver, glass bangles. Here, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is wearing sandalwood bangles and anointed with pulp of sandalwood. So, like people who take that chandan, so there is sandalwood, chandan ki lakdi, and covered with pulp of sandalwood. So, chandan. He especially wears these decorations to dance in Sri Krishna Sankirtana. Right? When we do Nagar Sankirtan, we dance. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu danced a lot more in ecstatic dancing of Krishna. Esa Bhagunalana Muni Vaishampayanam.
Esa Bhagunalana Muni Vaishampayanam.
Sahasranama Kaile Tanara Nama Gananam.
Sahasraname Kaila Tanara Nama Ganana.
Recording all these qualities of Lord Chaitanya, the sage Vaishampayana included his name in Vishnu Sahasranam. Jai Ho. Did you know this? That Vishnu Sahasranam has name of Lord Chaitanya?
No, I don't know, Prabhu.
Yeah,
most. Who is this sage?
Vaishampayana is the author of Vishnu Sahasranam. Not author, who documented, I should say. I mean, author ultimately is Supreme Personality. So you have various rishis like Vaishampayana, Jaimini, like that. You have these key rishis in the scriptures. So Vaishampayana is one of the sages.
So, Prabhu, so Vishnu Sahasranam was compiled a long time before, right? Or before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to this material world.
Yeah. So, scriptures are not linear. Scriptures can talk about avataras that are coming in future, avataras that are happened in the past. Right? If you see Bhaktivikas Maharaj, he is regularly giving various lectures on YouTube, and each lecture is just one word of the Vishnu Sahasranam. Recently, he gave a lecture on Manada. Right, I'll show you. Yeah, this is one of the names. So Krishna's name is Manada. Manada means somebody who is respectable. And then he followed on with Manya. You see this Manya, which is Krishna's culture of respect. So,
continuing Vishnu Sahasranam, the name Manya, which the basic meaning is respectable. He who is worthy of and should be respected. Now, this word Manya, or this name Manya, this designation Manya, it is one of those names in Vishnu Sahasranama which is applicable particularly to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but not only to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The name Narayan, for instance, or Vishnu, is applicable only to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Of course, someone may be, some child may be given the name Narayana or Krishna, but in terms of the name's meaning, it is only applicable to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Whereas other names in Vishnu Sahasranama, they may be applicable in a lesser degree to others also. So Krishna is not the only respectable person. He is the most respectable, but others are respectable also. And those who are familiar with Indian languages know that the word manya is in common usage even today. For instance, we speak of the manya Mukhya Mantri or manya Pradhan Mantri, the respected chief minister of a state within India, or the respected prime minister of the Republic of India. And it's not only for politicians, it's a commonly used word to denote that such a person is respectable and we also respect him. If you say Manya Mukhya Mantri, you're not in the mode of a cartoonist or a political rival who wants to pull that particular politician down. So it is a commonly used word, but we should know that ultimately the respectable, the person to be respected is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And we should know why someone is respected.
So these are Vishnu Sahasranams, different words. So Maharaj takes one word at a time and discusses that, basically. Right?
Very nice, Prabhu.
Yeah, when you have time, you should... Yeah, Bhakti Vikas Swami.
Okay.
He's my spiritual master. I got initiated from him, 12 years ago? Yeah, something like that. And I traveled with him to Croatia, to Slovenia, to Russia. So it was very, very blissful experience going with him.
You already traveled Croatia, Russia, all the parts, right?
Yeah, yeah. I went with him. Otherwise, I don't know where these countries are even. So I went with him and then I was able to kind of understand what is going on in those countries with him.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Got it.
Right. So yeah, Sage Vaishampayana, who I wouldn't say exactly wrote, because ultimately this knowledge comes from Krishna himself, but he documented, we can say, the Vishnu Sahasranam. But it is said that Lord Chaitanya's name, even before he was on the planet, was already documented. Lord Chaitanya's name comes in many Upanishads and Puranas. In all 18 Puranas, somewhere or the other, Lord Chaitanya's name has been mentioned as a hidden avatar, Gupta avatar.
Yes, Prabhu. Also, as per my knowledge, when Jayadev Goswami was there, so he went, when Jayadev Goswami was plucking the flowers, so Navdeep, so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared in front of him, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu instructed him, because he was looking on, Jayadev Goswami was looking for you know, Radha Krishna, Prema, some kind of, you know, deities of Radha Krishna. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared and said that, okay, you go to Jagannath Puri and stay there. And very soon I'll be appeared in the, you know, in the Navdeep. So that was also, you know, before also appearing, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also appeared in front of Jayadeva Goswami.
Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came in Tukaram's dream in Maharashtra. He came either in the dream or he came as a voice to one of the Sikh gurus in Punjab. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was always there. It is, yes. You know, we tend to ignore him, but he has been there all along. So, you know, giving his mercy to many, many acharyas throughout the country.
Yes, Prabhu, and since like all of the dhams, they have their spiritual significance, like, so the same thing also, that is also should be, you know, Mayapur dham or, you know, or Navdeep dham in the spiritual planet. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is always deciding, right?
Right, 100%, 100%, yeah. Okay, let's continue. Dui lila chaitanyera adi arashesham.
Dui lila chaitanyera adi. One second. Dui lila chaitanyera adi arashesha.
Dui lila ya chari chari nama vishesham.
Dui lila ya chari chari nama vishesham.
The pastimes of Lord Chaitanya have two divisions, Adilila and Sheshalila. And he has four names in each one of these two Lila. So total of eight names. So we'll come to those names slowly. Suvarna Varno Hemango.
Suvarna Varna Hemango.
Varangaschandanangadi. Sanyasakrucha Mahasanto. Nishtasanti Parayanah. In his early pastimes, he appears as a householder with golden complexion. His limbs are beautiful. His body smeared with pulp of sandalwood. Seems like molten gold. Right? When gold is melting, it will say budu, 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 like that, right? With like uneven surface. So the chandan on the body of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu seems like molten gold. In his later pastimes, he accepts the sannyasa order and is equipoised and peaceful. He is the highest abode of peace and devotion, for he silences the impersonalist devotees. Yeah, like he was, you know, having arguments and winning those arguments with Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, who was more inclined towards impersonalism, right? So he silences the impersonalist devotees. Okay, Manoj, please read this.
This is verse from Mahabharata, Dana Dharma, Vishnu Sahasra Nama Stotra. In this commentary on the Vishnu Sahasra Nama called the Namaratha Sudha, Srila Baladeva Vidyabhushan commenting upon this verse, asserted that Lord Chaitanya is the Supreme Personality of Godhead according to the evidence of Upanishad. He explains that Suvarna Vanaha means a golden complexion. He also quotes the Vedic injunction, Yada Pasyaiha Pasyate Rukma Varnam Kartaram Isam Purusam Brahma Yonim Mukunda Malasutta. Mukunda Malasutta.
No, this is not Mukunda Mala. This is Mundaka Upanishad.
Okay, sorry. Mundaka Upanishad 3.1.3. Rukma, Rukma Varnam, Kartaram Esam refers to the Supreme Personality of Godhead as having a complexion the color of molten gold. Purusha means the Supreme Lord. The Brahma Yoni indicates that he is also the Supreme Brahman. This evidence too proves that Lord Chaitanya is the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna. Another meaning of the description of Lord as having a golden hue is that Lord Chaitanya's personality is as fascinating as gold is attractive. Srila Baladeva Vidyabhushan has explained that the word Baranga means exquisitely beautiful. Lord Chaitanya accepted sannyasa, leaving aside his household life to preach his mission. He has equanimated in different senses. First, he describes the confidential truth of personality of Godhead. And second, he satisfies everyone by knowledge and attachment to Krishna. He is peaceful because he renounces all topics not related to the service of Krishna. Srila Baladeva Vidyabhushan has explained that the word Nishtha indicates he is being rigidly fixed in chanting the holy name of Sri Krishna. Lord Chaitanya subdued all disturbing opponents of devotional services, especially the monists who are actually averse to the personal feature of the Supreme Lord.
Yeah, monists means impersonalist. They are averse to personal features, so they don't like the personal feature. Once I was distributing books, and I said, yeah, this is a personal God. Oh, and then one lady said, oh, God, personal God. So God is a person like that, right? So people are shocked to know that God is a person. So,
yeah, Prabhu, on this regard, I want to know if you have time, Prabhu. So first of all, the impersonalist, right? So we did talk about impersonalist. I know a little bit about the Buddhism, right? Buddhism has the monist philosophy. We don't believe in scriptures or...
No, Buddhism is more than monism. Monism is the impersonal aspect. Buddhism is no okay. aspect. No aspect means nirvana, becoming nothing. So that is another challenge. This is a different challenge. That's why Srila Prabhupada said nirvishesha shunyavadi. Nirvishesha is the first part. Means God is not a person. He doesn't have distinct qualities. And Shunyavadi is voidism. So Buddhism is voidism, becoming nothing. There is nothing. So you work hard all your life to become nothing. Like, so that's a different challenge.
How they worship? What is the conception of worshiping? So then I just want to understand that, Prabhu. So then do we know Krishna?
Just sit and meditate on nothing.
Okay. Meditate on nothing, right, Prabhu?
Yeah.
Okay.
And again, there's so many variations of Buddhism also. So some people eat meat and they say, oh, it is good. You have to liberate the animals. That's why you eat meat. Some people don't eat meat. Ahimsa Parama Dharma. So it's like a lot of confusion going on.
Yeah. And the real Buddhists, actually, they also don't eat onion garlic. This is my understanding.
Yeah, I mean, not eating onion garlic is just to come to mode of goodness, but to accepting God's position, right? Like, you know, Srila Prabhupada here, he uses a term. Let me show you that. Renounces all topics not related to service of Krishna. Renouncing is not like, you know, oh, I'll renounce my job or I'll renounce my family or my house. Renouncing means renouncing all topics not related to service of Krishna.
Yes, Prabhu.
This is a very important distinction. Most people think, oh, yeah, I'm renounced. I left my job. I left my wife. I left my children. So now I am so elevated. No, renouncing means renouncing all topics not related to Krishna. To service of Krishna. Again, not just dryly saying, oh, Krishna is great. No. Service. You have to serve Krishna physically, mentally. Manasa karmana vacha. Mind, actions, and words. And then Valdeva Vidyabhushan says, Nishta means rigidly fixed in chanting the holy name of Krishna. That is Nishta. We are not there, right? If you write first with the what is the stage? You come in contact with devotees. Then you go through some attraction to this process, right? What are the steps that Rupa Goswami gives? Sorry, what was that?
Prabhu, I forgot, Prabhu.
Like you get ruchi, asakti, bhava, prema. In that ladder, what are the first two elements? Sadhu sangha, bhajana kriya, anartha nivritti. Remember these stages?
Yeah, I had these stages, Prabhu.
First is shraddha. You have some faith. Then you do sadhu sangha. You come in contact with devotees. Then you do bhajana kriya. You actually start your devotional life. And then Nishtha is an advanced stage after those first four levels. Then you go to Nishtha. Sorry, what was your question, Manoj?
No, Prabhu, I got it. No. This is from the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, right, Prabhu? Correct. So you said the first one would be the Atatha Brahma Jignasa, right?
Atatha Brahma Jignasa is an aphorism from Vedanta Sutra. First stage is Shraddha. You have some faith.
Shraddha.
Yeah.
Then sadhu sangha.
Then you do sadhu, you come near sadhus, then you start bhajana kriya. So we are doing that. We have come in contact with sadhus, Prabhupada, and then doing some bhajana kriya. But then Nishtha is a more advanced stage. That's when you rigidly fix yourself in chanting the holy name of Krishna. Okay. Vyaktakari Bhagavate Kahe Bara Bharam.
Vyaktakari Bhagavate Kahe Bara Bharam.
Kali Yuge Dharma Nama Sankirtana Sara.
Kali Yuge Dharma Nama Sankirtana Sara.
In Srimad Bhagavatam, it is repeatedly and clearly said that the essence of religion in the age of Kali is the chanting of the holy name of Krishna. Iti dvapara urva iti dvapara urva isham.
Iti dvapara urva isham.
Stuvanti jagadishwaram.
Stuvanti jagadishwaram.
Nana tantra vidaneha.
Nana tantra vidaneha.
Kalavapi yathashunu.
Kalavapi yathashunu.
Okay, in this way, people in Dwapara Yuga worship the Lord of the universe. In Kali Yuga, they also worship the Supreme Personality by the regulations of revealed scriptures. Kindly hear of that from me. So this is also taken from Srimad Bhagavatam, where sage Karabhajana is telling, is discussing rather, I should say. Krishna Varnam Tvisa Krishnam.
Krishna Varnam Tvisa Krishnam.
Sangopangastra Parsadam.
Sangopangastra Parsadam.
Yajnaihi Sankirtana Praye.
Yajnaihi Sankirtana Praye.
Yajanti
Sumedasaha. Yajanti Sumedasaha.
In the age of Kali, intelligent persons perform congregational chanting to worship the incarnation of Godhead, who constantly sings the names of Krishna. Although his complexion is not blackish, he is Krishna himself. He is accompanied by his associates, servants, weapons, and confidential companions. Okay, yes.
Yeah, from the, I cannot see the top part, Prabhu. Okay, this text is from Srimad Bhagavatam. This text is from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 11, chapter 5, page 32. Srila Jiva Goswami has explained this verse in his commentary on the Bhagavatam, known as the Brahma,
wherein he says that Lord Krishna also appears with a golden complexion. That golden Lord Krishna, Lord Chaitanya, this age. That is confirmed in Srimad Bhagavatam by Garga Muni, who said that although the child Krishna was blackish, he also appears in three other colors, red, white, and yellow. He exhibited his white and red complexion in the Satya and Treta ages, respectively. He did not exhibit the remaining color, yellow gold, until he appeared as Lord Chaitanya, who is known as Gaura Hari. Srila Jiva Goswami explains that Krishna Varnam means Sri Krishna Chaitanya. Krishna Varna and Krishna Chaitanya are equivalent. The name Krishna appears with both Lord Krishna and Lord Chaitanya Krishna. Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but he always engages in describing Krishna and thus enjoys transcendental bliss by chanting and remembering his name and form. Lord Krishna himself appears as Lord Chaitanya to preach the highest gospel. Please call down, Prabhu. Lord Chaitanya always chants the holy name of Krishna and describes it also. And because he is Krishna himself, whoever meets him will automatically chant the holy name of Krishna and later describe it to others. He injects one with transcendental Krishna consciousness, which merges the chanter in transcendental bliss. In all respects, therefore, he appears before everyone as Krishna, either by personality or by sound. Simply by seeing Lord Chaitanya, one at once remembers Lord Krishna. One may therefore accept him as Vishnu Tattva. In other words, Lord Chaitanya is Lord Krishna himself. Sango Upangastra Parsadam further indicates that Lord Chaitanya is Lord Krishna. His body is always decorated with ornaments of sandalwood and with sandalwood paste. By his super excellent beauty, he subdues all the people of the age. In other descents, the Lord sometimes used weapons to defeat the demoniac. But in this age, the Lord subdues them with his all-attractive figure as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Srila Jiva Goswami explains that his beauty is his astra or weapon or to subdue the demons. Because he is all-attractive, it is to be understood that all the demigods lived with him as his companions. His acts were uncommon and his associates wonderful. When he propagated the Sankirtana movement, he attracted many great scholars and acharyas, especially in Bengal and Odisha. Lord Chaitanya is always accompanied by his best associates like Lord Nityananda, Advaita, Gadadhara, and Srivas. Srila Jiva Goswami cites a verse from the Vedic literature which says that there is no necessity of performing sacrificial demonstrations or ceremonial functions. He comments that instead of engaging in such external pompous exhibitions, all people, regardless of caste, color, or creed, can assemble together and chant Hare Krishna to worship Lord Chaitanya. Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishnam indicates that prominence should be given to the name of Krishna. Lord Chaitanya taught Krishna consciousness and chanted the name of Krishna. Therefore, to worship Lord Chaitanya, everyone should together chant the Maha Mantra, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. To propagate worship in churches, temples, or mosques is not possible because people have lost interest in that. But anywhere and everywhere, people can chant Hare Krishna. Thus, worshipping Lord Chaitanya, they can perform the highest activity and fulfill the highest religious purpose of satisfying the Supreme Lord. Srila Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, a famous disciple of Lord Chaitanya, said, "The principle of transcendental devotional service having been lost, Sri Krishna Chaitanya has appeared in order to deliver again the process of devotion. He is so kind that he is distributing love of Krishna. Everyone should be attracted more and more to his lotus feet, as humming bees are attracted to a lotus flower."
Very nice. Very, very nice. So, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, who argued initially with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but then became a disciple of Lord Chaitanya, said, "Since the principle of transcendental devotional service is lost, Lord Sri Krishna Chaitanya appeared in order to deliver again the process of devotion. He is so kind that he is distributing love of Krishna." Just like we say, right? Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gaurasvise Namaha. In the Prasadam offering prayers, we say this. Om Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gaurasvise Namaha. Okay. So we'll stop there. Any questions?
No, Prabhuji.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thanks for the class, Prabhu. Sorry, today we are traveling and we are outside also. So it will be next Saturday also, the same time, 7 p.m. class, right, Prabhu?
Yes, 7 p.m. If there is some change, I will let you know, but that is the normal time. Because in summer, we are also doing a number of festivals in the Seattle area. If there is some festival, then I'll cancel the class.
Okay, Prabhu, okay. I'll just check the group. Okay, thanks, Prabhu.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.